You asked and we answer.
How to build a buyer's list.
Oh, it's a great question. It's really not that important in the beginning, because having 50, 100, 300 buyers but no deals doesn't get you paid.
Doesn't do anything for you.
So I'm not saying don't build a buyer's list, but I'm saying if you are right now sitting here watching this video thinking, man, I need to build this buyer's list before I start marketing, what am I going to tell you, Mike?
Don't do that. Get some marketing going today. Buyers aren't really interested unless you have a deal. So again, it's there you go.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, you don't need a buyer's list. Dave, we had a buyer's list of what, 10 or 15 or
12,000 people.
20,000 people.
Exactly. 12.
So this was a couple, like maybe a year or two ago. And we went back through it and we looked at who actually opened emails. And it was like a third.
Oh, not even. Yeah. It's terrible.
So we said, forget it. We don't need this. We don't need a massive buyer's list. What you need is to find active buyers.
Active buyers.
That's what you need.
That's what matters.
So get out to a networking event or...
which is the best place to find them. Real estate investment associations or RIAs or real estate clubs, whatever you want to call it. People meet. They get together. They have coffee. Sometimes presenters will come in and you network and you meet them.
And if you can't do that right now, check out
meetup.com.
Exactly. Tons of virtual stuff happening right now. So hop on that bandwagon, get on Facebook, find out who's active, who's buying properties. Those are your buyers.
Those are your buyers.
You don't need 20 buyers.
Right.
You need one buyer for each deal.
You know, one other great way to find buyers is once you have a deal, market it. And your phone will start ringing and those people are buyers. So as they call you, add them to your buyers list. So incredibly simple, right? That's so, where most of our buyers came from, is from deals that we had under contract that we put out to market to find them. There's a lot of ways, though.
Another way, bandit sign. You're using a bandit sign to go and find a seller, right? Take that same yellow sign, stick it in the yard of the property you have under contract.
Must sell.
Yeah.
Three bed, two bath, call me.
Motivated seller, selling fast, phone number. Again, you're going to have people calling. And guess what? They're going to be people who want to buy in that area.
Love that.
Boom.
Call real estate agents that have sold houses in the vicinity. Ask them if they're buyers. They're clients. These guys get paid when their clients call them to buy or sell something. Ask them if their clients are looking to buy more properties in the area. They get paid. They're going to go to work for you. My personal all-time favorite place to find buyers is PropStream, because I can go in and I can type in a zip code. I'm talking, I can get down to like, I can even draw on the map like 3 to 5 streets around my subject property, and I can pull a list of those people. And then I can call or text them.
Super.
Or I can just get their email and send them all an email and say, hey, I noticed you bought one down the street. I got one. Do you want to buy it too? So there's lots of ways to build your buyers list. I do want to also drop REI Black Book in as a reference, because with REI Black Book, Mike and I use them to do a lot of our wholesaling and dispositions. You can create a simple landing page and have a simple link that you can text or email people, and it'll allow them to actually opt in to get your emails as well. And you can share that all over social media, and you can actually build a pretty decent sized buyer's list.
I love that.
Just from sharing a link with your friends, right? I love it. Want to see an example? Go to discountpropertyinvestor.com/VIP. This link I set up back in 2016, it still works today. It's a web form that says, hey, do you want to look at some properties in St. Louis that are going to be discounted for landlords or for rehabbers? Great. Tell me your name, your phone, your email, and then check a couple little boxes on where you want to see the deals. That way I don't send you deals that you don't want to see. But that's it. Start with the marketing. Having a buyer's list is important, but check this out. If you don't have one, you can still sell your deals by listing them and publishing them and marketing them on Craigslist, Facebook Marketplace, Facebook groups, and maybe even list on the MLS as owner by contract as an option. So many ways.
Trust us. Finding the deal is so much more important than having a buyer's list. We have a buyer's list. Guess what? If we don't get off the couch and do anything, our buyer's list makes us $0.
We haven't even used the buyer's list that we have, which is roughly 4,000 to 5,000 people, in the last 3 to 4 months that much. I'd say 30 to 40% of the time, because the other 50 to 60, 70%, whatever the numbers are, we have a buyer already lined up for it because we've done the networking at these real estate clubs, and we know that our buddy Tim buys in this neighborhood and our buddy Jimmy buys in that neighborhood. So we already know in advance, right? So again, don't overthink it. Just do the marketing. If you have a deal, the buyers will come. And if you got a deal in St. Louis, reach out to us. You asked, we answered.